India is a podcast platform for social issues and for issues that matter. We started Suno India, me, my husband, and another friend, Tarun. So Tarun, Rakesh, and myself, three of us started Suno India last year. And we started this, honestly, from a place of frustration that the content that you see, especially when it comes to certain issues, are just not available. And also because we felt like people were just reacting a lot and not really listening. And so that was one of the reasons why we went with podcast as a platform. And so, yeah, it's just been a little over a year since we've started Suno India. We just celebrated our first birthday in September of this year. And we started Suno India with a podcast on child adoption. It's called Dear Pari. It is India's first podcast on adoption. And it stems from our own journey of adopting our daughter. And we wanted to sort of share our journeys and also journeys of others like us who have adopted. Also to sort of break through the taboo and the stigma that still surrounds adoption as a topic. And since then, we have now created over 14 shows on a range of topics, from current affairs to climate change to rare diseases to, you know, now we have a really cool show, you know, on body image. So, you know, and there are like very different sort of diverse shows that we have created. It's actually been really heartening. We have now close to almost 2 lakh listeners across the country. We have one show which is on careers in Hindi, on alternate careers. So I think that a lot of youngsters don't seem to know about careers beyond, say, engineering or beyond doctor or beyond accountancy. So we started Ra. Tarun felt very strongly about, you know, the need to put out information about this. And that show is doing tremendously well. It's just been 6 episodes, 2 months old, and it's just doing phenomenally. And I think like the response has been great. I mean, it's a new medium, right? It's not something that, it's not like YouTube, or it's not like, you know, it's not video in that sense. So initially it was a bit slow, but I think the pickup has been fabulous. Also because we're choosing very niche topics and we have a very targeted approach towards our listeners too. And we're sort of catering to, okay, this is what is missing in terms of information. So here's what we will put out for you in terms of information. Definitely, I think, look for niches. I think what really works in a platform, in a medium like podcast, sorry, not platform, but in a medium like podcast, is definitely identifying, okay, what's the niche that you want to sort of talk about, bring information out about. What is, again, the format or the style that you want to do? Because you have different formats, you have different styles, even in podcasts. So somebody might just be doing an interview show, right? I mean, that's the most popular format that's right now there, out there. But again, how do you want your show to stand out? Like, what is that one niche topic that you would do? So, for example, someone might be interviewing people who have had fantastic journeys. So, you know, an entire show might be on that. I know somebody who has a podcast just for bikers. So just identify that niche, look what is it about your podcast that will make it stand out. And I think like every creator says, just be yourself, be authentic, and make sure that the information you're putting out there is as authentic and as real as it can be. And I think it stems from the fact that if you put somebody on a pedestal and if there is a fall that happens, then that fall actually hits you really hard as a follower. And so I actually don't look up to anybody in that sense. Growing up, I adored Sachin Tendulkar, but that just came from a very fangirl sort of a phase. I think people who have sort of kept me going definitely are, I'll give a lot of credit to my husband, Rakesh, who's also the co-founder, because he sort of believed that we could do this, you know? And I, you know, at a time when I was like, are we going the right way? You know, isn't this too risky to like just set up your own thing? And I think just helping me take that leap of faith, or rather he just pushed me off the ledge and he said, you can do it. For that, I think a lot of credit goes to Rakesh. And Tarun, I think he was the one from the beginning who was like, this is going to work, let's do it. You know, we have collective skills among all three of us that we should be putting out there. We have the knowledge, we have people whom we know can bring sort of add value. So I think definitely my two co-founders will remain people who constantly inspire me and push me to do better. When I heard about Influencer Con, I was like, what is this Influencer Con? And when I looked up the lineup and the agenda, I found it really interesting. Also the kind of workshops that are out there. And I think it's a great sort of an event and a great place for creators to come together to talk about, you know, how do they create and sort of to take people through the back end process. I think a lot of people who are followers of creators don't really know the kind of hard work that goes into putting out a piece of work, whether it's video, whether it's an Instagram post, or whether it's, you know, a podcast. I think a lot of people just don't know the process of putting that, you know, piece of creativity together. So I think InfluencerCon in that sense has been, I think, is a great idea, and I think it's a great platform for people to come learn, you know, educate themselves, engage with other like-minded people. But so far what I've experienced here has been really great, really positive, and I'm looking forward for the rest of the day.